Hello, everyone. Welcome to Nulle Part. Hopefully I'm pronouncing that correctly. So it's described as a psychedelic adventure game in which a nonchalant young man discovers a weird and chaotic world. Now, it definitely is weird and it's very chaotic, as you can probably see already. And be warned, it contains a lot of colorful flashing images. Like, really, a lot. I've only played it for a couple minutes just to make sure it works, and it most certainly does. So again, lots of colorful flashing images, so if you're prone to epileptic seizures or if that's a problem for you, don't watch. Because there's going to be a lot of it. So this game is totally free. I'll have a link to where you can play it for yourself in the description. And I heard about it from a site called CreepyGaming.net, which is a really nice resource for finding games that are, well, most of them are actually free. But it's a really nice resource for finding games that you might otherwise not hear about. So I'll have a link to that also in the description. Now, as is normal, I like to take my time with the games that I play, go slow, and just kind of think about them a bit, analyze them a bit. So I'll be doing that as usual, and that's all there is to mention. Let's go. As you can hear, the music is interesting. It's chaotic. It's just as chaotic as the visuals. It just sounds completely off. And yeah, the movement is interesting looking. I like the way his legs kind of squirm about as he moves. Very strange. Anyway, I can go to the bed if I wanted to quit, which of course I don't. Or I can go to this, I guess this is a door, to start. So, let's go. What the? Weird fucking dream. Yeah, no kidding, Daniel. So yes, there's gigantic things flashing around the outside, and then there's these green dots that seem to follow me. Kind of. They actually seem to be slightly repulsed by me. But they also follow me at the same time. Right. So I have no idea what's going on. I'm in some sort of a bizarro dream world in which everything is mutated into a virtually unrecognizable state, except for these trees. I can recognize that this is a building of some sort with a door, and these are trees, but beyond that, not really anything. Hello, thing. Apparently its name is Arcelius, or however you pronounce that. Man, we're so lucky to be here. Inside this island. It's a horrible mess outside. Yeah, I guess it's safe and all, but don't you find it a little boring? Well, you clearly haven't been outside. I just barely got in here. I'm sure I would have gone insane otherwise. If this is what you consider the boring world, Daniel, then you're kind of crazy. Because this isn't even close to boring in here, although I have to agree, it does look a little bit more chaotic outside. Can I talk to the tree? Nope. Hello, head with spider legs thing. I'm not even gonna try to pronounce their names, they're too complicated. When I was brought here, I was watching TV with my wife and kids. We were trying our best to ignore the cat. Why? Well, let's say he was a little deformed. He had three legs coming out of his back, and he made a strange noise when he opened his mouth. And all of that because of those perturbulences. What's a perturbulence? I know what perturbed means. I know what turbulence is, but what is perturbulence? Hello, green blob. Algard. See what I've got here? That's the most precious thing I have. I have to say, I actually don't know what you have there. It looks like a... maybe a piece of paper with glitter on it? That's a grocery bill. Exactly. That's my only memory from the real world. And I feel like if I let it go, I'll forget who I am. You're taking it a bit too far, I think. Well, things like that are important here. Important enough that we keep objects like this safe, in the hole in the labyrinth. God damn it, everybody here's insane. Yeah, well, this entire world looks insane, so I guess it fits. Hey, there's another person who actually looks like a humanoid. Like me! Anyway, is this a tree or is this another creature? Well, whatever it is, I can't talk to it. Let's talk to the man. Hi, what's your name? Daniel. You? Hi, Daniel. I'm Paul. So you've just arrived? You don't seem too surprised. Why would I be surprised? My dreams are always fucked up like this. Alright, I understand. Listen, you're not in a dream. Yeah, right. How come the last thing I remember is going to bed? Coincidence. Besides, don't you think this could have something to do with the perturbulences? The perturbulences? Isn't that those weird people who started to hallucinate badly? They won't stop talking about it in the news. Hallucinate? I don't think you heard it right. Yeah, well, I don't know. Perturbulences doesn't mean a whole lot, for starters. The media gave a stupid name to the phenomenon, but that's besides the point. The thing is that, since the last few days, there's been all kinds of strange events in the neighborhood. The neighborhood? This doesn't look like a neighborhood. Are you even listening? The neighborhood where we all were before we got here. At first, there were all kinds of weird shapes, sounds, and colors. And then there were all kinds of impossible events. That's exactly what I was saying. Hallucinations. When everybody sees and hears the same things, it's pretty hard to explain it with hallucinations, and... Oh my god, this is so fucking boring. Can we, like, do something? You still believe this is a dream, huh? Yep. I went to bed, then magically appeared here. You're sure nothing happened between you sleeping and you being here? No. Alright. If you won't listen to me, go. You're wasting my time. Go talk to someone else, play, do whatever. Have fun. Hey, thank you, Paul. I shall. Let's go talk to this thing. You seem pretty normal. You must not have been here long. What do you mean? In case you haven't noticed, people don't really keep their normal looks here. We all end up slowly transforming, even if we stay inside the shelter. I guess I'm going to turn into one of them. It's the cube that built this mighty fine place here. The cube? Yep. I tell ya, it's our savior, the cube who crafted some fine shelters for us folk. Shelters? There's more than one? Why certainly, my boy. We aren't the only ones who got saved. If you ask me, it's God himself who sent us his prophet, the cube, to protect us. Well, I guess it's real nice of him to do that then. You know, the perturbulences started right on my street. Let me tell you, I was scared as shit. But what was I gonna do, just leave? Yeah, I didn't see any of that. Just heard about it on TV. What? Tell me, how the hell are you here then? Look, I don't know. I just went to sleep and got here. I'm surely in a dream. I certainly hope so, Daniel. I want to go home, I want to go home, I want to go home! Help me! Yeah, I can't really help you with that. Fuck this crazy-ass motherfucking shit. I fucking hate this place, just kill me and it'll be over. Calm down, man, look. I'm sure you'll get to go home, eventually. Yeah, the cube says the same thing. But has someone left here yet? No, Not a single fucking person. Hmm. Well, if it's a dream, then I should wake up. At some point. Right, Daniel? I knew I should have left when the perturbulence has started. It was so strange. I'm sure it has something to do with where we are now. I think that's everyone. I think so. Wait a minute, have I talked to you? Yeah. Okay, so it looks like there's two places to go. Inside of this building, and down this hole. Let's go inside of the building first. Nah, I don't feel like going there yet. Okay, down the hole we go then. Nah, I don't feel like going there yet. Okay, then where do I go? What if I talk to Paul again? So, having fun? No, but I'm curious about what you were saying earlier. I won't waste my time explaining it if you're not going to take me seriously. If you do what I tell you, I'll explain my theory about what's going on, alright? Okay. It's not like I've got anything better to do. Go in that hole, there. Catch the sounds, and take the hidden object. Then, go take the object that's in the labyrinth and come back here. And all that's for what, exactly? You'll see. Take this bag and put the items in it. Some of them might be useful. Okay, so... see ya? Yeah, later. Okay, X. So that's the bag. Okay. Right, so I guess I can move around to the different items if there were items, but there are not. Okay, so I need to catch the sounds, apparently. We shall see how this goes. Whoa. Okay, I'm seeing things drip. Whoa. Whoa. What is this? Oh my god. Time and these little dots moving, and then they're waves. Oh, I can. Whoa. Okay, I can hear sound. Whoa. Like I'm hearing. I'm hearing sound coming from a certain direction. Like above me. Have I captured any? I don't even know how I capture them. Okay, what if I go to the center of the ring that just went out? Okay, oh. Whoa. Hi? Am I about to capture one of the sounds? Where am I? A lighter. Is that one of the sounds? A lighter? Or is that unrelated? I don't know. Let's talk to this... man? Hello. You came to take the item. You're not supposed to, you know. But... it's not like I'm going to run after you. Okay. Your legs do seem to be kind of deformed, so... I'll just be on my way, then? Right. Goodbye. Okay. Is that one of the sounds, or is that just a lighter? Can I use it? I don't know how to use this here. Okay, ooh, the hole is a lot smaller. Do I just need one? He says something about, like, the labyrinth. I don't remember exactly what he said. But let me go back to him, see what he says. So, did you get the items? I got one. Do I use it on him? No, okay, yeah, I need more. I think I need all of them. I can't seem to go in. Oops, didn't mean to talk to you. Yeah, I don't believe I can go in. Is there, like, another hole that's opened up somewhere? Do I go inside of the building? Oh, there we go. What is this place? It's an altar that says X. Is that a hint to open up my inventory? Whoa. What the heck? Am I supposed to dodge the wall? There's a doorway there. Right, can't use it. Why does it say X? It's like it's telling me to use my inventory, but... Let's go through here. You better leave now. You staying here, I cannot allow. Okay, so I need to avoid this stuff here. Hold on, I want to know. What happens if I get hit? Apparently it zooms the game in? What the hell? Now I can't see anything. Oh my god. Okay, thank you. Once again, this is X. Two ways to go. This area is off limits for the inhabitants of the island. Please leave immediately. I'll make it quick, okay? Your presence is endangering the integrity of the whole shelter. For the well-being of the island, it is imperative that you leave immediately. I just want what's in the chest. I am now forced to use deterrent security measures. Please take note that you will be responsible for any inconvenience this may cause. Oh my god! Okay, let's grab what's in this chest before I die. An empty paper bag. Why is this so important? I don't know. I'm gonna explore around before I leave, though. Oh my god, my eyes. Wow. Wow. Anything else around here? Nope. I'm gonna leave now. Oh. Oh, sweet relief. Okay, what's up here? I don't know how to use this here. I don't know how to use this. I don't know what says X. Makes me think I should open my inventory. Whoa, 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 whoa. Okay. Right, so there appears to be nothing in here. I wonder what that is, like, the block moving to the side. Is it just a random thing to try to trip you up, or are you supposed to do something with it? Like, does it reset? Because this one went over before, and it doesn't look like it's doing it now, so it doesn't look like it does reset. Right, oh god, what is happening? Everybody's freaking out. Whoa, what's going on? Paul? Paul! What? Calm down.
Ah!
Calm down. Can you hear me? Shit. Just let go a little bit. It'll be harder if you resist. Damn, what? Tell me what's going on. Where am I? Alright. My theory is that someone or something brought us here. But I don't know exactly why. One thing's for certain. The usual laws of nature don't operate here. In fact, it seems like there are none. It takes some getting used to. But it has the potential to be some sort of paradise for those who can take it. And that's precisely the problem. Some people aren't willing to accept this new reality. What do you mean? Well, that island we just left is a good example of that. When people first arrived here, Cube, a living cube, created those island shelters to reassure them. The thing is, it prevents anyone from getting out, and he tries to scare us with the outside. Okay, and why does he do that? Well, he seems to think that we're not meant to live here, that it's too dangerous. He seems to be unable to cope with the absence of laws. But, I mean, we're all right here, aren't we? I'd even say I'm starting to like it. Exactly. Cube's lying. But people believe him. They take him for a god. And the only way to shake some sense into them is to destroy their shelters. Wait a minute. You mean that's what we just did? Destroyed their island? Are you insane? Don't worry, we didn't hurt anyone. At worst, some of them are scattered across this place, but they'll survive. Okay, so what do we do now? We go destroy the other islands. As long as there will be references to our old world, we'll never reach the full potential of this new universe. Think about it. A world without rules. Total freedom. So, where are the other islands? There's 8 left. Since you know how it works, you can go on your own. I'll go take care of some other islands while you do that. But where's the next one? Go right. Oh, I guess I'll follow him. Wait, do you mean like... my screen, right, I guess? What? Oh, am I going somewhere? Oh yeah, those green things were around another island. I wonder if they're... Nope, they're just gone. Is that... Nope, that's not it. Didn't seem to work. Unless I need to use this thing. Oh, I just tried... Oh, looks like it did work. Alright. Okay, I think I know what I have to do. Still, this is all pretty fucked up. Yeah, and by the way, buddy, it looks like you're transforming a bit. Your arm and your leg look a little bit different. God, I love the imagery in this game. It's so strange, but just so fascinating to look at. Ah, the perturbulences. It's all bullshit. It's clearly a secret experiment by the government. We were selected, and now we're in a big underground lab somewhere. You really think someone would build a place like this? And you think a talking cube's plausible? Are you that dumb? It's all made up. The cube's just a robot controlled by the CIA or some shit. It's pretty obvious. Yeah, sure. Sure, sure. Oops, already talked to you. What are the people that saw us disappear doing? Do they miss us? Will we see them again? Do they know where we are? Are they coming for us? I don't think they do know where we are. I don't think they're coming for us. And I think you ask too many questions. Jeez, way to be a dick, Daniel. Wait, I haven't talked to both of these. Which one did I talk to? Oh, I can't seem to talk to the orange spider thing. Oh no, there we go. I've got a weird question for you. Yeah? Do you think I look more like a man or a woman? It's just that I feel like I've been here for an eternity. And I can't remember what I was before. I don't know, man. Does it really matter here anyway? I don't know. You don't look any more like one than the other. But you did just say, I don't know, man, so I guess, I don't know, that's strange. Hello, spidery lump of redness. That was a strange noise. I don't know you, but you seem trustworthy. Can I tell you a secret? Wow, okay, we've already moved to the friendship stage. Well, yeah, I guess. I'm not sure I really hate this place. I mean, it's all colorful. A bit intense, but I don't know. Really not that bad. I think I'd like to go outside and experience it fully. I might be able to help you with that. We'll talk later. You look more normal than the others. Do you want to be my daddy? No. I had a daddy before, but now he's gone. And mommy too. Sorry, little boy. Girl, I'm just not cut out to be a daddy. Oh, okay. Aw, come on, don't cry. Everything's gonna be fine, I guess. Don't say it to anyone, but I've heard someone destroyed an island. Yeah? You have an idea who it could be? Not at all. I don't know what kind of maniac would do such a thing. Thankfully, the cube started to reinforce the shelters, but I'm still worried. The little wooden fence doesn't make me feel very safe. Yeah, you look rather stretched. Everybody talks about the cube, but let's not forget that X helps us a lot too. You mean the big red X who speaks like a robot? I just think he speaks properly. If you think that's speaking like a robot, it says a lot about your education. Yeah, yeah, go right on ahead. We'll see what happens with you later. What do you mean? Is that a threat? Oh no, of course not. Forget it. I'm bored out of my mind and I don't know what to do. Well, didn't you have some kind of pastime before? Yeah, when I didn't know what to do, I used to go saw some random piece of wood. Felt good. Okay. Sounds like a lovely pastime. I think I've talked to everybody. Yeah, let's go on down. Let's find the sound. Ooh. I'm gonna go towards the oh, okay. Well, the waves are coming from multiple places. I do hear a sound to the left, though. Now it's from the right. Okay, here it is. I wonder if those distortions, I think those distortions all over the screen mean that I found it. And then I gotta find the next one. Here, you again. Do you have a new item? Come on, could you just leave that there, please? Is it really necessary that you steal from me again? I'm real sorry to cause you trouble. It's nothing personal. But it's really, really important that I get this. Fuck. What a brilliant idea that was, making a big fat dude like me the guard. Yeah, wasn't the brightest. An old teddy bear that smells like shit. Great, a shitty smelling teddy bear. Wonderful. Teddy bear! Okay. Oh, those blocks are doing their thing again. Gotta be on the lookout for that. This area is off limits for the inhabitants of the island. Please leave immediately. I know, you told me the exact same thing last time. Your presence is endangering the integrity of the whole shelter. For the well-being of the island, it is imperative that you leave immediately. What are you, some kind of machine? I am now forced to use deterrent security measures. Please take note that you'll be responsible for any inconvenience this may cause. Oh, great! That again. A handsaw. I guess this could be useful. Ooh, there's a certain person who likes to saw wood. I don't have any wood, but I do have a saw. Okay, let's leave before I die. Before my eyes fall out of my head. Oh. Oh, sweet relief. Okay. Who was it that liked a saw? Nothing's happening. What did I do wrong? Do I need to do something with the items? Well, I already know what to do with one. Was it that guy down there? Wait a minute. Have I spoken to you before? Oh, yeah, I did. And is it you? Yeah, it is you. Okay, let's give you a saw. Didn't work. Would you like a teddy bear? Didn't work. Would you like a bag? Didn't work. Would you like a lighter? Didn't work. You're the one that likes to saw, right? Yeah. I used to go saw some random piece of wood. Okay, I don't have wood, but I have a saw. I would have thought that would have worked. Alright, Dweller was the one that was... wanted to get outside. Supposed to talk to him later. I don't remember which one that was. Oh yeah, it's you. We'll talk later, okay. Okay, so if I don't use the saw on them, what do I do? Wait, what the hell? I don't know if you can see this on the screen. Ignore? Yes. Okay, is the game still working? Yeah. Okay. You probably couldn't see that in the recording, because it was a separate window, but as soon as I tried to use the door, it popped up with an error message. I just pressed ignore until it went away. Yeah, a little bit buggy, I think. Okay, so... Wait a minute, what about the little kid? Which doesn't look little or like a kid, but what if I give them a teddy bear? Or I can give them a paper bag to play with. I've heard kids love paper bags. Who was that? Who was it? I don't remember which one it was. Oh wait, it's you, isn't it? Yeah. Do you want to be my daddy? No, but do you want a shitty smelling teddy bear? I don't know how to use it. What the hell? How do I use this stuff? I don't get it. I can't use the teddy bear on the child, nor can I use the saw on the person who likes to saw wood as a pastime. So... what the heck do I do? I'm very confused. I was pretty much sure that was the solution. To use the saw on the person who saws stuff. I would try to enter the building again, but it's probably just going to give me an error message, and I don't see the point. There was only one chest, and I got everything from it. What if I talk to them again? So maybe someone has something special? I mean, just like Paul, when I talked to him again, you know, it changed. I'd swear it's the saw for this person. I don't know how to use that here. Do I need a saw off wood? Like, can I saw off the ladder? Do I need to saw a tree? Doesn't even look like they're made out of wood. I don't get it. Whoa, what'd I just do? Oh, I saw the railing. Right, someone did say that it looked unsafe. I suppose that makes sense. And done. I let everyone out, or everything in, or both? Is that Paul again? Is he the thing of... Nope, that's just part of the background. Alright, well apparently if I go to the left... Or at least last time I went to the left and I found it, so maybe I'll... Whoa. Maybe I'll do it again. What is that? Oh, do I need to avoid things? Like, is this a minigame where I need to avoid getting hit by stuff? That thing pushed me back. Yeah! Okay. Whoa. Why am I huge? Why am I so huge? Oh my god, I'm large. What the? What? I've become enlarged and now I'm a character. What in the hell is going on? This is now a platformer. The cube says, hello. Hi. So you're the cube, I guess. Yes, I came here to warn you. Stop destroying my shelters. It's not me. Not only you, no. You and your friend Paul. Alright. I promise I won't do it again. You're free to roam on the outside, but don't ever come back on any of my islands. We'll see about that. Oh, looking good. Looking good, Daniel. What the hell was that? I just walked inside of myself? Fuck. Yep, that sounds about right. I know what's going on here. Oh, you do? Well, please tell me. We're all dead, and this is hell. The perturbulences. That was the apocalypse. When you die, you can't know for sure what you're dead. That you're dead. That's how hell works. You'll try forever to get out, but you'll never succeed. This is why hell is the worst of tortures. Let me get this straight. Nobody knows that they're dead. Except you. Yeah, I know. But I'm dead, but I know. What? Yeah, you get some real ironclad logic there, buddy. You look like a good listener, so listen up. A little while ago, I was outside and I was hearing this word repeated over and over. Man, that word was making me feel good, like relaxed or something. Must have been the name of God or some shit. Sounded like hygiene or aging. What? Hygiene or aging, those don't even sound alike, but I'm gonna write them down just in case. Hygiene or aging? Might be important. Oh look, they have little loofahs for hands. I heard that, like, you know, I guess someone said, like, you know, the cube said something in the sort of, like, about something about somewhere, you know, like here or someplace. That, you know, it's sort of like someplace in the, you know, that the place was, like, you know, some kind of something, like, built or something, you know, the whole place by some, like, you know, like, by someone or something, or, like, you know what I'm saying? No, I didn't quite get that. Could you, like, you know, make it clearer for me? Like something or someone, the cube, you know, he said like some sort of like, you know. Ah, never mind, man. Yeah, I'm gonna go over here. Goodbye. Where did you come from? I never saw you before. I came from outside. Outside? I thought I heard that nobody was allowed to come in anymore. Yeah, well, I have special permissions from the cube. Oh, really? Is there any way we could verify that? Just ask the cube next time you'll see him. In any case, glad to meet you. See ya. You look like a piece of toast, sort of. Maybe a piece of toast with blueberries embedded in it? And ketchup arms and feet? Yeah. All of this is hard to understand, and really hard to accept. Just before arriving here, I was at my wedding. The priest was about to declare us husband and wife when suddenly, because of perturbulences, our love manifested itself physically as a kind of sprawling multicolored light. It was the most beautiful thing I ever saw and ever will see. And now, I'm here all alone. How sad. I'm worried for my friend Gargant, the guy who guards the chests in the holes. Oh yeah, that's the gigantic guy that can't move, basically. Someone stole his objects twice, and it's starting to affect him a lot. He's starting to have suicidal thoughts.
Oh, what? No!
And I have to steal them. Wow. Man, that's so sad. If I ever see him, I'll try to cheer him up. Oh, thanks, dude. That's really generous of you. You're a great guy. I'm the one that's causing him the disturbance in the first place, so I don't know about that. Damn, we're waiting after a fucking cube and a giant X to save us from a place that I don't even know where my arms... A place that I don't even where my arms went to see some guy named Richard is a nice guy he likes to disguise himself as a sunny day on the highway to be a rotational boiling road device fishing? Road vice fishing? Simultantric ardent ropey hungry fit element? I don't know. I'm not sure I quite got that. Me neither. The guy who's blowing the shelters that the cube so nicely built. I understand him. I'm starting to want to fuck everything up too, to light shit on fire. This place is... there's a bunch of words there. Shit. Yeah, it wants to light stuff on fire. What about my lighter? Alright, it's starting to look like I don't give objects to people, but instead I use them. But I have a hole to visit before trying to do that. Not to mention more people to talk to. Hold on, I talked to you, right? Yeah. Shit. Islands are falling left and right. Damn maniacs are destroying everything. The cube's gonna have to do better than that. Otherwise, we're fucked. At least he reinforced those damn fences. He did. I'm not going to be sawing them anymore, but I guess I'm going to be burning something. Oh, talked to you before? I've talked to you. I think I've talked to every... maybe not everyone. Nope, talked to you. Talked to you? Yeah, I think that's everyone. Yep. Down the hole we go. Either above me or below me. There we go. It's to my right. above or below me? It's below me. Maybe not. Oh, here it is. You again. I need to cheer him up. You again? Go ahead, take it. I don't care. Nothing affects me anymore. Take it, go play with your friends, break everything, burn the whole fucking place, I don't care. Aww. Oh, I can't even use objects, I can't... Like, I can't even give him something to cheer him up. I can't open my inventory. A banana peel? Is this a joke? I really hope it doesn't kill himself. Can you even kill yourself in this world that has no laws? Like, the laws of nature don't even apply? Right. There's a hole. And there's another hole. Alright, two holes. Right, this is gonna be a maze. Let's go through this one. Oh god. Am I back to the Yep, I'm back to the beginning. Let's go through this one. Freaking maze. I have no idea anymore. Right, I'm just gonna go through random doors until I find it. Does this place have no doors? Yeah, it's got none. This one it is! Ah, there it is. There it is. You're making a big mistake. So, you've decided to talk to me. What's your goal in all this? You're the cube's bitch, and you do what he tells you? The cube and I share a common goal, to ensure the integrity of the shelters. Like I said, you're his bitch. No, we share a common goal. Our methods differ. But we come from the same being. What? You're the same person? No, concept, the cube. Eugene and I were the same concept. Wait a minute. Who's Eugene? Sadly, I will now have to remind you of that. Your presence is endangering the integrity of the whole shelter, for the well-being of the island is imperative that you leave immediately. Ah, shit. You'll make me blind and deaf again. Yes. Okay. I have to say, your defenses are not that effective. They're disturbing, but they don't stop me from taking what's inside of this chest. A gas can. Too bad I don't have a car. Oh god, I have to find my way out now, don't I? I do. Shit. I'm stuck. I can't move. Oh no, it bugged. It freaking bugged out. I'm stuck. Okay, well, I heard the game saves automatically at the start of every level. Or maybe even every room. I hope it's every room. So, yeah, I'm gonna have to close it, so I'll be right back. Alright, I'm right back to about where I was before. It does have a save system, but it doesn't actually restart at the last room you were in. It actually restarts the level, the entire island. So I went through the maze again and collecting the sounds and all of that, and it actually did the same problem again, except it froze. My character froze before I even found the chest, not after it. So this is now my third attempt. The first one you saw, the second one was off camera, and this is my third attempt now. So I just got the item, and I just left the room that I got the item from. And I'm hoping this time it doesn't freeze up. I don't know what's going on with that, but yes, please let me leave. Actually, I think I came from down here. Oh, apparently I didn't, because there's no door there. I just want out of the maze. Don't trap me in here. Oh, I made it out, and I can still move. Oh, okay. Right. So, I think I need to burn something, but the question is what? And how exactly do I do it? Because I have a gas canister and a lighter. I'm guessing I need to use the gas canister first. Oh, there we go. I discovered the building and... Yep, discovered the building and gas. Can you guess what I'm going to do next? I'm going to start sawing the building down. Aw, it didn't work. I'm gonna put a paper bag. Oh, no. Okay, I'm gonna burn it. Burn. I'm gonna run away now. Goodbye. I didn't do it. Is it working? Is it spreading? I have to say, for having coated the entire building in gas, that's a relatively tame fire. Oh, and I just tried to use the door. I meant to look at the flame, but it's giving me another error message. Ignore. There we go. Okay, now what? Oh, I still have the items. Maybe I can use it on the railing? Oh, I can light, like, everything on fire. Even the bushes. Okay, we're gonna cause chaos. The inner pyromaniac is coming out. Alright, just a little bit more. My view's getting obscured. I think I need it to get, like, totally obscured, and then it'll probably finish. There we go, got some smoke going. Cool. Almost. Do I have to do every single bush? I think I do. Oh, there we go. Huh. Got some kind of platforming, I guess? I'm good. Why are you doing this? To be, you know, free? Look, I'm not really sure. But it seems to me like the right thing to do. People aren't happy in your shelters. And you think they're happier now that you've killed them? Why do you think they're unhappy to begin with? This universe is not designed to support human existence. Everything I did was to create an environment in which coherent human existence could continue. Of course, this process is long and imperfect, and all that's temporary until I complete the bridge that will bring you all back to reality. Reality? What if I want this to be my reality? That's impossible. There's only one universe where humans can exist. Here, without the shelters, everything would quickly melt in a mixture akin to nothing. See, that's the problem. Who are you to decide that I can't stay here? If I want to try and live here, I should be able to. And everybody else, too. You're free to stay outside until you can get back to the real world, although I do not recommend it. But I cannot let anyone here. It's too dangerous. What's the danger exactly? I don't believe you. I think you're making this up to scare people. I thought that you would have been able to understand, even after what you did. It turns out that you're too stupid to conceive the consequences of your actions. I will have to eliminate you. Yeah? Go ahead and try. Oh god. Okay. Oh, god. Do I need to run away or do I just avoid them? Oh, and I'm on fire. No, I just need to avoid them. Alright, I'm a little bit burnt, a little bit toasty. But I'm alive. Your flaming boxes can do nothing. Actually, that kind of hurts. Okay, your flaming boxes can do something. I think I made it. Oh, this is my ship thing again. I can move. Let's continue to the right. Whoa, where'd I go? I just got eaten up by the background. Where the hell? What in the hell? I'm the little thing in the top left. Okay, let's avoid getting... Ow. Let's avoid getting hit. Oh my god. Ow. Son of a bitch. Let me in. Okay. Time. They gotta time it better. Ah, damn it. There we go. Okay, whew, I made it. What's happening? Everything's red, but I'm still here. Do I need to leave? Like, where do I go? Back up? Okay. What's wrong? I don't know. I'm having a hard time. I'm separating. Fuck, concentrate. You can do whatever you want, just concentrate. I can't do it. Ah! Shit, we're gonna have to merge. We don't have the choice. I can't hear anything. Help me, Paul. Okay, I don't have a choice. Oh. Oh, this is weird. My name is now... Ponyel. Our names have merged as well as our bodies. Ponyel. I feel smarter and stupider at the same time. I can't believe I did that. So, now I'm alone against the cube and X. If something like what I just did's possible, imagine without those two, what we could do. I'm talking to myself now? Fuck. I'll have to get used to this. Alright, time to go. Let's hope I don't get eaten again. I'm being followed by a trail of dots. Come with me, my little ducklings. Also, why is it totally silent? Where's the music? Where's the sound? Where's the chaos? Oh, look at them splitting. And merge the dots. Pretty. I'm not sure what I'm supposed to do, though. I'm all the way to the right, and nothing's happening. Let's head to the left. Oh, it's this thing, isn't it? Yeah. There we go. Last island. I guess I will soon find out the true nature of this place. These people look surprisingly humanoid. Surprisingly humanoid. And I'm looking more and more less so. I look really fucking weird, is what I look like. Jesus will grant you forgiveness if you repent. God will accept even a demon like you in his kingdom if you give him your heart. Okay, I'll just finish what I was doing and consider his offer after. Yeah. Hello, sir. Your feet appear to be made of fire. How does that make you feel? Will you at least give us a good show with fire and shit? I promise that when this is over, you'll get to see all the fire you want. Yeah. I can't stand it here anymore. I'm with you, man. You mean you're gonna help me? Nah, I can't do that. Just in case you lose and I have to stay here after. Alright, well, thanks for your support, I guess. That isn't even support. In other words, I like what you're doing, but I don't want to put anything on the line to achieve it. Gee, thanks. Hello. Please spare me. If you do, I'll give you something in exchange. A special secret about the cube. Something that could help you. Alright, tell me and I'll spare you. Okay, here we go. The cube is actually as big as one of its edges cubed. Wow, thanks for the help. I'll always remember you. That wasn't helpful, even remotely. I don't get how the cube hasn't stopped the crazy people trying to destroy us yet. I ask myself the same question. At least he's forbidden anybody from coming in here. Yeah? So that means if you ever saw someone new, you could be pretty certain that he's one of them. Yeah, I hadn't thought of that. I'll keep an eye open from now on. I'm new. But don't think about it. Hello, demon thing. Are you a demon clown? What are you? Please, I have a wife, or a husband, and kids, or cats. I'm just a humble taxi driver, or trucker. Anyway, I don't deserve to die. Or do I? Shit. I don't know. Just don't hurt me. Ah, help! It's him! Calm down. I won't hurt you. Liar. I know what you did to the others. Someone help! Okay, they know me. I'm not scared of you. There's nothing to be scared of. I'm here to help. Come on. Come here, you stupid ass. I'll fuck you up. What? Look, I don't want no trouble. Yeah, I'll show you what trouble is. I'm gonna make some trouble in your face! Okay, bye. You know, my face feels rather untroubled. Well, actually, my face looks like a fucking horror show, but... yeah. Let's see if I've spoken to everybody. You and you and you, Mr. Firefeet. Mm-hmm. Okay, is there no hole? Do I just go straight in? I guess I just go straight in. Where's the door? I don't see a door. Is it the sound? I hear sound coming from here. Ah, you gotta follow the sounds. Or, wait. Wait, I just went back out. Yeah, sorry. Gotta find the other one. Here we go. Right. That, oh, God. Where did it just teleport me to? I'm all the way back outside again. Okay. Oh, the hole is inside of the building. Well, let's head down. Wait, where's the chest? Are you okay? Do you know why I'm here? To guard the items? No, that's why the cube asked me to come here. I'm talking about the reason I accepted. No idea. The cube said that if I did my job well, I'd be back in the real world in a few days, before all the others. But you know what? That's impossible. What's impossible? Going back to the real world. Completely impossible. What? How do you know that? That guy in the labyrinths, Labiro, told me. And you believe him? Yeah, I do. Even if he's a little bit insane. So, what are you gonna do? Give me your bag. Huh? Why? Give it. Okay. I guess I don't really need it anymore. Here you go. Okay. Wait a minute. Here. With this, you can light things on fire instantly. What? Come on, stop fooling around. Just burn this fucking place already. Oh, God, what the hell? Yeah, if I press my inventory item, it just burns stuff instantly. Okay. Are you sure? I guess I have to. Okay. Have I burned enough? There we go, that should do. Whoa. Oh crap, I need to actually avoid these things. What in the hell is happening? Oh my God. Where do I go? It looks like it almost burst through to the lower part, but it's not happening. It's not quite connecting. Is it getting closer each time? Oh, whoa, I just pressed the use key and it just, like, burned it. Oh. Alright, you can't hit the sides, but I can hit the top. I'm not sure if I'm resetting all the way to the top or what. Okay. There we go, bursting through another border here. Burning this place to the ground? Is there even a ground? I don't even know if there is a ground in this place. Aw, man. I'm getting so close, but so far away. Ah! Oh my God. I'm never gonna get through this. Everything is so fuzzy, it's really hard to tell exactly where I am. Oh god. Jesus. Oh, got smashed. Got smashed. Got smashed. Jeez, very first one in the second wave. Wow. Second one in the last wave. Ooh, think I got it. Yep, I got it. Okay. Unless there's yet another wave. No good. Okay. Oh, I think I got it. The situation is extremely problematic. Yeah, for you. I do not understand the hatred that you have for me. This isn't hate. It's just that you and your friend, the cube, you're dangerous. The danger comes from the unpredictable, the irrational. We are rationality. What the hell are the X's in the text? We are order. We are secure. I'm just gonna forget the X's. We are security. Those concepts don't even exist here. Your statement is false, because we are these concepts. And we exist in this universe. Yeah? And what's happening, like, right now? The cube lives on, and he will clean this place from the damage you have done. This place will stabilize or disappear. And the basic laws of reality will be maintained. Yeah, yeah. Are you gonna tell me who that Eugene is or not? Oh god, so many X's. This is the something, it's breaking. It's broken. XXX, just pure X. Where am I? Hello? Is there anybody here? Oh, whoa. Cube. I don't understand. What don't you understand? Why did you encourage chaos in this way? Or freedom, as you say it? Freedom, fine. But to do what with? Everything. Since the beginning, humanity is stuck in the same old frame of action. It's so inflexible that there never is any real change. Over and over, we let ourselves do the same mistakes. Don't you get the potential this place has to help us? How naive. You really think that by removing the rules, all of humanity's problems will disappear? Haven't you considered that this ultimate freedom left in the hands of human nature, which you have just described, is an extremely destructive weapon? I can't let Eugene make such dangerous manipulations. And I certainly cannot let you impose your way of thinking on the universe. That Eugene again. X told me about him. I'd like to meet him. Seems like we'd get along. Unfortunately, you won't get to, because you'll have to be eliminated. Too bad. Okay, what? Oh, whoa. I guess I need to avoid the cubes from the cube. Mini cubes! Cube Wars! Alright, I can avoid them. Ow. Ow. Wait, so, like, do I need to get close to them or something, or do I just... Whoops. Do I just avoid them? Because I could continue to avoid them pretty easily. If I just stay really far away so they spread out as much as possible. I think maybe I need to get close, because it's resetting me back to the bottom right corner, which makes me think I need to get close. Oh, yes, okay, I just burned it a little bit. Ah. It's gonna be hard to get close to it now. Yeah. Oh, so close. There we go. Another one. Gonna burn you down, Cube. Ooh, wow. Okay, it's spraying him out pretty fast. There we go. I see a place to enter. Alright, so you gotta go in from down here, I think. And go down like that. Okay, yep, gotta do that, but just gotta be faster. Let's wait for the next wave. Here we go. Go up. Go. Ah, oh, damn it. Nah, it's too late. Yeah, I gotta be, like, pretty close to there when that wave comes. But I see where I'm supposed to enter. I see it. Here we go. Here we go. Oh! Almost had it! Oh, got it. Got it. Yeah, so the way I need to enter, but like the patterns which I need to enter from, are getting more complicated. Wow, that lighting really is distracting. Oh, got it. Oh, shit. I just skipped some text. Accidentally. I was mashing Z to try to flame it. Anyway, I guess I got it. Good. Before you die, I've got a question for you. Is it true that it's impossible to get people back to their original universe? Yes. Why? You're all just copies. You continue to exist in your world. Eugene simply took the information that composed you and brought it here. I'll be damned. Are we outside now? What the hell happened? I destroyed X in the cube, and it seems to have settled things down a bit. Wow, never felt better in my life. Thanks, man. I heard you made the cube go away. Is that true? Yeah. I had been outside before and was excited about the potential that it could have, but I was soon disappointed to see that the cube's influence was holding it back. Thanks for having dealt with him. You're welcome. They're happy. I wanted to come thank you personally. You have no idea of all that's now possible thanks to you. No problem. I guess I'm a local hero. This is crazy. I'm in several places at the same time. And I'm able to absorb the knowledge of everyone I meet. I feel like God, but you're God. All that's thanks to you. I love you. Look, you seem like a nice person and all, but I want to merge with you. I don't mean to offend you, but I've had my fill of merging. Yeah, I'm good. Hi. Hello. Do you want to be part of my superorganism? We'd be really honored to share our intellect with you. I'll think about it. What you've made possible. It's insane. This is something that has never existed before. I don't know how I could call it. Is more than liberty, like Ultra Liberty. It's as if all of a sudden, there were no more rules and it was total chaos. But on the other hand, I feel like nothing's ever made so much sense. You, what you did, you, what you are, it's like chaos and liberty at the same time. Chaerty. Liberos. You're special. You've become something new. You're like inside my head. Now I think and how I think and how I feel. How everyone feels here. I call that ultra liberty. I guess they've coined a new term. I'm this thing. What the hell am I? And where am I? Hello? What are you? That's Eugene. Hello, I am the Perturbulence, but Eugene is my personal preference. Hi, I've heard about you. I'm Paul Nulle. You can keep that name if you cherish it, but what you really are is Ultra Liberty. And what does that mean? It means that you have become a concept. One that never before took shape in the sphere of living thought. I am a concept, and you? I now am the Perturbulences. I once was rationality, as the cube X and I were the same being. Huh. And what made you separate? Rationality died, and we emerged from his body and three distinct beings. Our disagreements finalized our separation. Okay, now you're the Perturbulences. How did it happen? Since the death of rationality, I have a strong desire to achieve the ultimate freedom of matter. In your initial universe, I tried to create a space that went in this direction. The Perturbulences resulted, but I quickly hit limits that I couldn't overcome. The result was far from what I had hoped. I need a more stable, suitable environment. I discovered the universe from where you just emerged, a place much more suited to my goals. Okay, wait a minute. You said I was also a concept. Ultra Liberty. How did that happen? Since you represented the new freedom that the people of your new universe had acquired. You were born here. Here being... Nulle part. The realm of ideas. So when an idea or concept becomes concrete enough in people's minds, it appears here? Yes. And in this way, I was brought here as the Perturbulences. After rationality's end, Cube X and I weren't representing anything. So we cannot exist here, and we ended up on Earth. My experiments, which were named as the Perturbulences, left a sufficient enough mark in the human psyche for... My rebirth here? Being here gave me access to an infinity of universes. This is really complicated stuff. I'm not sure if I quite got everything. This is a good example of the partial success of my experiment. What do you mean? What experiment? I had a precise goal in mind when I copied people from Earth into the other universe. I wanted to create a concept that precisely represented the ultimate freedom I crave. I needed a mind already initiated with these ideas. Someone able to embody the concept I had in mind. I found a young man named Paul who met these criteria. Okay, and what about the Daniel part of me? Daniel disrupted the process. Your merger diluted the equality of your intellect and your general understanding of events. So, what are you saying? I'm a failed experiment? No. Despite my disappointment, your help would be very valuable in my quest. If you want to, we could, together, try to reach a far greater level of liberty than what you currently represent. They seem to be multiplying. There's more of them. More and more and more. Alright, looks like that's the end. Wow, holy crap, that was one hell of an experience. That deserves a good stretch.
Oh, that feels good.
Oh, yeah. Nothing like a good stretch. I've just stretched my mind, and now I just stretch my body. Let's see what happens. Oh! The game shut down. Okay, well. Wow. That was an experience. I'm not even sure how to talk about it. That was crazy, in a good way. I can confidently say that I've never played a game quite like it. I don't think I've ever played a game even kind of like it, actually. That was insane in the best of ways. Wow, just, wow. Yeah, I'm honestly not quite sure how to talk about it. Other than, it was strange. I love the visuals and the music. Everything was just broken and distorted, but also very colorful. And there's a lot of movement. It's almost like sensory overload at times. With all of the flashing and the colors and stuff like that. And that was really interesting. You know, that's not something I normally see in games. It's kind of overwhelming at times, but... Like, sometimes there's so much stuff going on the screen that it's hard to see what's even happening. But I liked it. It's just so damn unique looking. So strange and unique. I'm fascinated by just by the visuals of the game alone. Yeah, some of the imagery just looks so good and strange and good. I'm not sure how to talk about it other than that. Just, yeah, I really like the art. Of course, a lot of it looks really crude too, especially the characters, but still, despite that, just the pure strangeness of it made it work, I think. And then there's some parts that just look genuinely beautiful. Yeah. And the soundtrack, well, matches it. It's kind of broken and distorted and strange. Just like the visuals. Really, I think the only thing I could really criticize is just that the actual gameplay itself is... I don't know, it was somewhat interesting, but also somewhat a little bit too formulaic for me. The fact that you're going to each island, and you know pretty much exactly what you're going to do. You're going to go into the hole, and then you're going to find the sounds. And then you're going to get the item, then you're going to go up, and then you're going to go inside of the building, and then find the chest through the maze. and then get the item and then leave. Like, it was pretty formulaic, which got a little bit old because I kind of knew exactly what was coming, even if it was coming in a slightly different format, you know, different noises that I was hunting for and a rearranged maze. But still, for a game that's so much about chaos and so much about just unique things happening and you have no idea what's about to happen, I found it a bit strange that the actual main thing that you're doing in the game is so formulaic. So that's a little bit strange, but that wasn't a huge deal. It didn't stop me from liking the game. Well, actually, I guess the only other thing I'd mentioned that didn't quite work for me, or could be improved, would just be the bugginess of it. The fact that I got stuck and couldn't move at all 2 times. Yeah, that was a bit annoying, but I got past it. And it didn't happen again, thankfully. But again, back to the visuals. Such strange and often beautiful visuals. And strange music. And the story is just, well, I guess every single part of the game, you could just say, it's strange. Same with the story. It's very strange, but it's also fascinating. Perturbulences. I mean, just the word itself, perturbulences, how bizarre. Yeah, just being thrust into this bizarre world and trying to learn its rules or its lack of rules. How things work and what's going on was really interesting. And I'm not sure what else to say about it. I'm at a loss for words, sort of. I really enjoyed it. Yeah. Alright, well, I guess I'll end it here. So that the end of this episode doesn't become 20 minutes of just silence of me going, do I have something to talk about? Yeah, I really enjoyed it. Strange and beautiful imagery. Nice music. A very intriguing story. That I think is only let down by some bugs and being a bit overly formulaic. But beyond that, it's really good. Alright. So, I hope you enjoyed my playthrough of Nulle Part, which again, I'm hoping I'm actually pronouncing that correctly, and it's not supposed to be pronounced in some more fancy way, like Nulle Part, or something like that. But, I hope you enjoyed it, and thank you for watching.